Hello everyone, I'm Jake Billing and today we're looking at this exciting new product from MN. Now this is the D90 1/12 scale miniature Land Rover Defender. Now this has four-wheel drive, working headlights and it's 2.4 gigahertz. Now this product actually comes in three colours. It comes in red, orange and green. This particular product is green. Now although this is a Land Rover, it also allows you to remove the roof so you can run it as a pickup truck. Now enough talking, this product has been sent to me today from banggood.com. If you want to have a look at this, there's going to be links right below. Take a look and pick one up. Let's get inside the box. Good old instruction guides. Shows you how to fit the extras to the truck. So here's that pickup roof I was telling you about. All the extra parts come in this little bag. And you can stick them to the body. I've gone ahead and done this already for us, so it's a bit easier and quicker. Like the door handles and the fuel cap and some little lights and things. It's pretty cool. Here's the truck itself. I must admit, it looks really nice. Just out of the box, it's got a great feel about it. It's quite heavy actually, and the suspension works as well really well. Now, if you look underneath it, you can see straight away you've got a four-wheel drive system going from the center to the front and then to the rear. Now unfortunately it doesn't have a digital proportional steering servo, so the truck is just on left or on right. It doesn't actually let you change that, but the acceleration is proportional, so it will allow you to drive as much forward as you want or back as you want, so you can crawl over objects a little bit easier. So this is the USB charger you get in the box. This allows you to charge the battery in about 45 minutes to an hour at the most. Looking at the transmitter, the steering is just left or right, it's not proportional. And the transmitter itself takes two AA batteries. And obviously the trigger is proportional, so the more you squeeze, the faster it will go. I must say, this transmitter is just a little bit too small for a man-sized hand. My hand doesn't quite fit in there. You know, it's a basic crawler, and I think we should look at the battery and the truck in detail now. So first things first, if we pop the bonnet, the hood, at the front here, you can see the battery sits inside. Now this is a 7.4 volt, 2-cell lithium ion pack. This probably should give you around 20 minutes of runtime. You can also upgrade this to a higher capacity battery because under the bonnet here, there's quite a lot of space. You could probably fit a much larger battery in there. So we'll just plug it in and just close the bonnet. Sorry, the hood, depends where you are in the world. And then as you can see, the lights on the front start flashing because it's looking for the transmitter. So we'll just switch that on. And as you steer or action the truck to move, they light up. So you can see the springs inside the truck. It's not too bad. The doors don't open. They're a sealed unit, they're just closed. But like I said, don't let that put you off because the truck itself has quite a lot of sort of substance to it. It feels quite heavy. I thought when I first opened this, I thought it was metal. A lot of the panels feel quite metal-y. They don't feel too plasticky like you'd expect. But overall, the truck looks really nice, especially the back. I think the back looks cool because you can kind of see through the back and the wheel on the back there is functional. I like as well how you can see the differential covers sitting in here on the axles. You can see the MN company logo stamped there, and it's stamped there. The roof rack's pretty cool. You could tie some things on this. Here's a big question. Does it pass the Jake Billing bounce test? It's got a lot of body roll. That's really funny to watch. But you know what? That should allow it to sort of maneuver over a lot of different obstacles. It's an awesome looking little truck. It's a 12th scale. And I love the little snorkel. I like the attention to detail on the truck. I like the fact it's got wing mirrors. I like the roof rack. I like the working real functional wheel on the back. Awesome. You can put some people in there, make it look a bit more scale realism. There's functional seats. I like the lights on the front of this truck. I think it would help you navigate at night. Kind of see where you're going a bit better. There's that snorkel and the roof rack and then the rear functional wheel. But the door handles I had to put on myself. These little side lights. Also the air intakes and the wipers and the wing mirrors under the bonnet. There's the battery hidden away. So what do you guys think to this truck? So far I'm kind of blown away with it. You're kind of getting a bargain. You're getting a ready to run four-wheel drive crawler, and all you need is two AA batteries for the transmitter. I mean, I love the headlights on the front. The tyres are really grippy, nice and meaty. It's got some nice attention to detail. The springs are really cool because they're red. And it passes the bounce test. My overall first impressions on this truck are very good indeed. For £45, $55, it gets you off the ground running. The only improvement I would have out of the box is a proportional steering servo, just so it makes it a bit better when you're trying to navigate over the terrain. So I know how I feel about this truck, it's absolutely awesome. How do you guys feel, and what's your favourite colour? Let me know right below in the comments and I'll get back to you when I can. If you guys are interested in this product, remember to have a look at my description box. You'll see the link to purchase this on banggood.com. $55, £45, but tell you what, it's a great gift. Everything you need is in the box. What more can you ask for? Bye.